stench. This place reeks of Falmer.
This must be their hive. We'll have to keep silent if we want to avoid drawing their attention.
Whatever you want to do, we're with you.
Bury my blade in your heart!
hasn't seen us yet. Brynjolf, watch the door.
Aye, lass. Nothing's getting by me.
Climb down that ledge. See if you can...
Carlyle, when will you learn you can't get the drop on me? When Brynjolf brought you before me, I could feel a sudden shift in the wind. At that moment, I knew it would end with one at the end of a blade. What's Carlyle been filling your head with? Tales of thieves with honor, oaths ripe with falsehoods and broken promises. Nocturne doesn't care about you, the key, or anything having to do with the guild. Wait a moment. Do I detect a hint of genuine avarice from this noble thief? Perhaps Carlyle and Brynjolf misjudge you, and your true nature is no different than my own. Never see the skeleton key as I do, as an instrument of limitless wealth. Instead, you've chosen to fall over your own foolish code. Then the die is cast, and once again my blade will taste Nightingale blood. Carlyle, I'll deal with you after I've rid myself of your irksome companions. In the meantime, perhaps you and Brynjolf should get better acquainted.
What's happening? I can't stop myself!
Your feeble attempt to hide is insulting!
He's taking control of
me! That's why I'm the best.
Get out of here before we end up like Mercer. Get out of here before we end up like Mercer.
This place is coming.
Sorry, lass. I've got important things to do. We'll speak another time.
I can't believe it's over. 25 years in exile, and just like that, it's done. All that remains is to ensure the safe return of the skeleton key. I'm afraid it's not that simple. When the skeleton key was stolen from the Twilight Sepulchre, our access to the Inner Sanctum was removed. The only way to bring it back will be through the Pilgrim's Path. It wasn't created for the Nightingales. It was created to test those who wish to serve Nocturnal in other ways. As a consequence, I have no knowledge of what you'll be facing. Brynjolf is needed back at the Thieves' Guild to keep order while you're away. And I can't bear to face Nocturnal after my failure to protect the key. I'm afraid you'll have to face the end of your journey alone. Take this with you. I'm not certain if it will help within the walls of the Sepulchre, but I certainly don't need it as much as you. I've had this bow almost my entire life, and it's never let me down. I hope it brings you the same luck. I've been a Nightingale for a very long time. I sold my allegiance to Nocturnal in exchange for many profitable years of thieving. Falling in love with Gallus was wrong. It was a distraction that allowed the Sepulchre to be desecrated, and it likely cost him his life. Until the key is returned, I will never set foot inside that place again. The conduit to Nocturnal's realm, the realm of Everglow, has been in Skyrim, well, longer than recorded history. The Twilight Sepulchre was constructed around it by Man and Myr in order to shield it from those who would exploit its power. It's through this conduit that we're given Nocturnal's greatest gift, our luck. What she gains in return is a complete mystery.
Sorry, lass. I've got important things to do. We'll speak another time.
What do you need? Come on in. Let me know if you need anything. Or take a seat by the fire and I'll send someone over.